Hi, I'm Dr. Rashmi Chaudhary, the consultant obstetrician and gynecologist in Cloud9 Hospital, Belandur, Bangalore. Pre-eclampsia is a syndrome complex. It is also known as the toxemia of pregnancy. It is characterized by hypertension, proteinuria, and edema. The timing of the occurrence of pre-eclampsia is mostly in the third trimester after the 28 weeks of pregnancy, but in certain cases it might appear early. The hypertension is to the extent of when the blood pressure is equal to or more than 140 by 90 millimeter of mercury, and it should be measured on two occasions at least 4 hours apart. These patients often they leak proteins or the albumins in the urine, which can be detected by the urine albumin examination on the spot. These patients often they develop the unexpected swelling in their body, the feet, the face, on the hands. The incidence of preeclampsia is about 5%. It is a very serious maternal condition which leads to several complications like HELLP syndrome or eclampsia, which leads to that mother starts throwing convulsions and fits, leading to serious complications. The genesis of preeclampsia or the cause of preeclampsia is not known, but there are certain factors which can aggravate or which can cause the occurrence of preeclampsia early. Or there are certain conditions in which we can predict that these women can have preeclampsia. The basic cause for preeclampsia is a faulty placenta. Placenta is a vascular connection between the mother and the child. In this preeclamptic woman, there is a faulty development of the placenta. There will be decreased formation of the secondary and the tertiary chorionic villi. These blood vessels, they are very narrow, they don't respond to the hormones, and they release this placenta, they release certain toxins or cytokines which causes the rise in the blood pressure, as well as there will be increased activation of the clotting mechanism in the body. Since the cause of placenta is not known, there are only certain risk factors, so we cannot do the cure or the primary prevention is not possible. We can just modify the disease process to improve the maternal and the neonatal outcome, like supplementation with vitamins, multivitamins, the calcium supplementation, as well as some antioxidant therapy and the antihypertensive therapy to improve the maternal as well as fetal outcome.